This video is an example of finding an expected value. And in the process of finding the expected value, I will be using the multiplication rule for probability and also the property that the sum of the probabilities in a probability table need to sum to one. Suppose that you and a friend are playing cards and decide to make a bet. If your friend draws three non-face cards, where a face card is a jack, a queen, or a king, in succession from a standard deck of 52 cards without replacement, you give him $10. Otherwise, he pays you $20. What is the expected value of your bet? All right, so the expected value formula is the sum of all of the x values times their corresponding probabilities. So for a problem like this, it's helpful to set up a probability table. Let me summarize what's given. All right, so we have 52 cards in a deck of cards. 12 of them are face, a jack, a queen, or king. And remember, there's four suits in a deck of cards. So four times three, three face cards is 12. So we have 12 face cards altogether. And then we have 40 non-face cards. All right, so we are looking for non-face cards in this problem. And another key point that is important to take a look at is the statement without replacement. All right, so I need to set up my probability table. I have my outcomes, and I want to write my outcomes out in words first, and that will help me translate to an x value, because we need a numeric value to plug into the expected value formula. And those x's will have a corresponding probability. So in words, we could have the outcome that the friend draws three face cards. And the key thing to keep in mind is without replacement. Okay. So we've got basically two events happening. The friend draws three non-face cards, or else, or otherwise. Okay, so I'm going to put otherwise as the second outcome. All right, so if the friend draws three face cards, it says in the problem that you give him $10. So if you're giving out money, that's going to be negative $10 for you. If the friend does not draw three face cards, and that encompasses a lot of outcomes or sub-outcomes there, otherwise you get $20, so that's going to be a positive 20. Okay, so we have the first couple of pieces for the expected value formula. Now, it's a little tricky to find this piece. So if the friend draws three, this needs to be non-face cards. My apologies. They don't make these kinds of problems straightforward, unfortunately. So if the friend draws three non-face cards without replacement, the AND rule for probability is implied. It means that the first card is a non-face card, and the second, and the third. So I'm going to be multiplying. So the probability that the first card is a non-face card, and I have 52 cards altogether, this first factor is going to be 40 out of 52. Okay, but that's for the first draw. I have two more draws because we are drawing three cards. Now here's where the without replacement is important. If the card is being put back, then we have with replacement and there is no change in the denominator. But because we are sampling without replacement, After the first draw, 51 cards are left. And because we are looking for face cards, and the first card was a face card, again, without replacement, I have 39 left for the second draw. So the probability that we get a non-face card on the second draw, given that the first card was a non-face card, is 39 out of 51. Okay, so same reasoning for this third factor. We have two non-face cards, we have 38 left. We've drawn two cards without replacement, we have 50 left. Now, you might notice, if you remember permutations, this is going to be 40 permute 3 divided by 52 permute 3. Or you could just go ahead and multiply straight across. So when you do that, this numerator is 59,280, and the denominator is 132,600. Now, for the case of everything else, this otherwise case, it's too lengthy and cumbersome to directly reason finding the probability here. So I'm going to use the property that this probability plus whatever this probability is has to sum to 1. Okay, so this plus this has to sum to 1. So using the rule of complementary events, and these would be two complementary events here, either he draws three non-face cards or he does not, is going to be 1 minus this probability. Okay, so it's much easier to use complementary events, the rule of complementary events in this case. All right, so doing that subtraction, I get 73,320 over 132,600. Now, the expected value formula is the sum of the probability, sum of the x's times their corresponding probabilities. Very easy at this point. You just have to make sure you don't make a typo in your calculator. This expression will be negative 10 times 59,280 over that denominator, and then plus 20, this x, times its corresponding probability. All right, so using my calculator and rounding to the nearest cent, because we're talking about winnings in dollars, I get positive $6.59. So because this expected value is positive for the player, and it's somewhat high for a game of chance, this would definitely be a bet you would want to take with your friend.